the purpose of Fast Forward is basically to recognize everyone for their hard work, not just the members of SPBC, but also faculty and staff around campus that worked hard, not just because they were required to work hard, but because they enjoyed it and they went that extra mile for what they wanted. So, at the end of this ceremony, we're also going to be announcing the new exec board for Students for the Propagation of Black Culture for the next academic year. So I know everybody's waiting to see who made what. So we're going to go ahead and get started and have a prayer for our
Arkansas, where he was immediately enrolled in school and accepted
accepted as a member to the local church. Charles graduated from Clement Hill High School in 1975 and enrolled at the University of Central Arkansas as a walk-on basketball player, where he later earned an athletic scholarship after graduating with both a BSE and a master's degree in kinesiology from the university. He began a 13-year coaching and teaching career at the several Arkansas high schools. In 1995, he returned to his alma mater, UCA, as the assistant coach for men's basketball. This career spanned across 8 years, ushering him into his next role as the university's first African-American head coach for men's basketball today. He works as a clinical instructor in the kinesiology department while also serving as the web developer for the Arkansas Basketball Coaches Association and the Arkansas Alliance for Health, Physical Education, Recreation, and Dance. Both websites emphasize educational growth and development for professionals in the field of coaching and physical education. He also works with many African-American groups on campus while serving as a mentor to numerous students. He has two beautiful daughters, Brittany and Brianna, and an amazing wife, Valencia Hurley. He is proud of the work he has done on campus and in the community, and is happy to call Conway home. Today, Coach Hurley, with all your hard work, you have made SPBC proud. Give Coach Hurley a round of applause as he comes to the stage.
Please give her a round of applause. This is a real honor, and it's a very humbling award. When I got the email, I was just really amazed that you would even consider me for such an award. But I do want to challenge all of you young people. Community service is extremely important. If you can give back to your community and impart a little bit of yourself into others, it will take you beyond your life on this planet. We have many opportunities in Conway and throughout Arkansas to plant you where you can make a difference in the life of another. And it's so important. It is so important to do what you can do to influence your little sphere. And so look around you, find ways that you can give back. You have so much to give, and I am so, so proud of you. Thank you.
Now we will present SPBC Outstanding Committee Awards. First up, Homecoming, Mia Robinson.
Thank you.
Okay, next we'll have Black History Month by Jeff Moran.
So, my first thing is, like, I'm a right-hand woman. She put up with me the whole school year, not just the month of February. She's always holding me down. And this award goes to Brittany. Honoring Black excellence, but like my committee went all out for me. They gave me all types of stuff, so I wanted to return the favor and give you your flowers while you're still here as well.
I remember he was really involved with SPBC last year. James was president, and he would always come to me, Dale, about running for president. I mean, not president, I'm thinking about running for executive board. And I said, you shouldn't. He's like, I don't know. I said, please do it, and he did it, and I'm just so proud of you, and I'm thankful to have you here. Jasmine, oh my God. Jasmine Wilson. Jasmine Wilson, I've been knowing her since our freshman year, and when I say, she kind of reminds me of me. She got here, she got involved really tough. A lot of people know Jazz. She's very popular. She has done a lot of things that has influenced a lot of young students here at UCA. And I am so proud of, you know, everything that you have enhanced about yourself, and I am very proud where you're going in the future. Kaylee Jackson, that's our quad baby on the executive board. She does a lot, and she is definitely a hard worker. This year she was an RA, she was on exec for AKA for the chapter here. And she has done a lot on this campus, and for her to dedicate her hours here for SBC was a blessing. So I thank you, Kaylee, and good luck to your future. Lewis, smile, and you know, Neil, she's somebody you definitely can talk to, you know. You can call her and be like, you know, I just want to get some stuff off my chest. And Neil, she'll definitely listen to your problems and give you good feedback, even if you don't want to hear it. And sometimes you're like, well, damn, you know, and you know, it is what it is. But I love you, Neil, and I'm definitely going to miss you. And you know, good luck to your future. Tiana Jenkins, let me tell y'all about Tiana. So, I was at MMP and I was a mentor. I couldn't find my mentee, and Tiana was my mentee. I went to the table, I think it was her and D Carr, and I sat down and said, hey, how you doing? I'm there, Yasha Sharp, I do this and blah, 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 what's your name? Oh, Tiana Jenkins, we're gonna have to leave, we're about to go, and she just left. I'm like, okay, I tried to introduce myself. So I said, she is rude, but I saw her throughout the semester, and she was always studying, she was always doing something positive. And I said, well, you know, I need to go back around her a little bit. And, you know, she ended up on the exec board, and she was a hardworking lady in SPBC. And look at her now, she turned Stroll Off out this year. We made the numbers go up, and I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of you, girl, for real. And, you know, good luck to your future endeavors. Tiana Benn. Yes, I do. Tiana is not going to sugarcoat anything. She is not going to, you know, she going to let it, she going to get a t-shirt. And I love Tiana because she never changed who she was. She was always the same. And one thing about Tiana, she did grow throughout this year. And I'm very proud of her because she worked on her flaws. And she came out of her shell. She's more talkative. She's more nice. She is. And like, now I can call Kiana, and me and her can just be on the phone. She said, girl, she sent me a something about the sweatlets from El Dorado the other day. I was just laughing because usually Kiana, me and her, our conversation just cut and dry. It's just business. But now I feel like we have gained that personal relationship. So I'm proud of you, Kiana. Jacqueline, and you know, while I'm talking about Kiana, she was the most improved on this executive board. She definitely deserved it. And we like to now acknowledge people who are most improved and the most valuable player. So give Kiana a big round of applause for everybody. This because Tiana came early and I said you can't open these.
We just dusting a little dust off the table. We'll make sure you give it to
Tiana. Can you step up and let us take a picture?
Sure. Oh, look at that emotion. Yeah. Shoot.
So, Jacqueline, I love this girl dearly, I swear I do. And, I said, give me a minute. Jacqueline, I met her freshman year, and I've told this story a million times. Me and Jacqueline, we did not care for each other, and I think it's because we had the same type of ambition, we had the same type of, not necessarily the same personality, because she got a stronger personality than I do, but it was just something about her that I was like, it's something about her, but we never connected until one day it was something on Music on New York or something like that. And I said, Jackie, you wanna take a picture? Cause we was always around each other, but we didn't never talk. And she said, yeah, girl. And then after that, it was just history. And she got on SPBC exec board, and she ripped really hard. This year she did an awesome job. Last year she did an awesome job. She does a lot for the community. And she's a great representative for our black women on this campus. And if no one looks up to her, you should be ashamed of yourself. And I love this girl, and I really do. And she's gonna go many places in life. She's been getting awards, she's been racking up this year. And I am so proud of her. And I love you. And you know you got MVP this year, so let's get her around.
Thank you.
sweet. Ms. Jackson, you know I love you. My parents, they moved, so she's definitely been like my mama's, you know, since my mom, you know, lives, stays away or whatever. And she's always there for me, and she always pushes me. And is there, like, literally every single time I need her. So thank you for that thing.
Coming into SPBC and as far as like being involved on campus, I really didn't expect the family that I gained. And yes, I would have to say Ms. Jackson is like another mother to me. Throughout anything that you need as far as advice or you just want to know when the next week event is coming up, Ms. Jackson is there. And I thank you for everything you've done and as far as pushing me to do better. And I love you.
I think Ms. Jackson's been in my life since freshman year. She was there, she knew I wanted to be an AKA from the jump. So I was happy to be I appreciate all she did for SPBC, been in all of our corners. She was there for me when I needed homecoming, she was there for me when I needed drug laws, she was just there. And sometimes it's the only thing we need someone there. So I appreciate you.
Hey, Pete, how you doing? But on a serious note, I just want to say I appreciate you because you really pushed me to do things I never thought I would do, like the SBC. I was one of the first organizations I joined, and it really made me become a better person, I think. It made me come out of my shell, and I see the potential of me being a leader, and I want to say I appreciate you and thank you for everything.
Agree with everyone. Ms. Jackson is definitely like the mother, like my other mom that I don't have. My mom, just like Kiana said, her mom is away. And so my mom was all the way in Nebraska. So whenever I'm stressed, I come to Ms. Jackson, I don't know what to do. She pray about it, just think it out, you know, come back to it and make a decision. But I feel like Ms. Jackson is one of the reasons why I have become a better leader and I am willing to take risks and to get out of my shell. And I, like Debbie also said, I am one of the quiet ones, but being around exec and just having that push and motivation from Ms. Jackson has made me be willing to take risks. And I just want to say I love you, Ms. Jackson, and thank you for everything that you have done for not only me, but this exec board. Thank you.
Somebody you definitely can talk to, you know. You can call her and be like, you know, I just want to get some stuff off my chest. And Nia, she'll definitely listen to your problems and give you good feedback, even if you don't want to hear it. And sometimes you're like, well, damn, you know. And, you know, it is what it is. But I love you, Nia, and I'm definitely going to miss you. And, you know, good luck to your future. Tiana Jenkins, let me tell y'all about Tiana. So, I was at MMP and I was a mentor. I couldn't find my mentee, and Tiana was my mentee. I went to the table, I think it was her and D Carr, and I sat down and said, hey, how you doing? I'm there, Yasha Sharp, I do this and blah, 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 what's your name? Oh, Tiana Jenkins, we're gonna have to leave, we're about to go, and she just left. I'm like, okay, I tried to introduce myself. So I said, she is rude, but I saw her throughout the semester, and she was always studying. She was always doing something positive. And I said, well, you know, I need to go back around her a little bit. And, you know, she ended up on the exec board, and she was a hardworking lady in SPBC. And look at her now. She turned Stroloff out this year. We made the numbers go up, and I'm so proud of you. I'm proud of you, girl, for real. And, you know, good luck to your future endeavors. Tiana Benn. Yes, Tiana is not going to sugarcoat anything. She is not going to, you know, she going to let it, she going to get t-shirt. And I love Tiana because she never changed who she was. She was always the same. And one thing about Kim, she did grow throughout this year, and I'm very proud of her because she worked on her flaws, and she came out of shell. She's more talkative. She's more nice. Something about the sweater that's from El Dorado the other day. I was just laughing because usually Kiana, me and her, our conversation just cut and dry. It's just business. But now I feel like we have gained that personal relationship. So I'm proud of you, Kiana. Jacqueline, and you know, while I'm talking about Kiana, she was the most improved on this executive board. She definitely deserved it. And we like to now acknowledge people who are most improved and the most valuable player. So give Kiana a big round of applause for everybody. I had to hide this because Kiana came early and I said, you can't open these.
We just dusting a little dust off this.
Works 24/7 for this organization for Office in Diversity. She works hard, long hours. Sometimes I don't even know how she does it. And without her, I don't even know where half of us would be or this organization, because you need somebody that's going to expect something from you. And Ms. Jackson is one of those people you can't just walk on campus and she see you in the organization and you go missing. She's gonna be like, where you been at? What happened here? And you're like, oh, okay, I guess I need to get back involved. And she's like that to everybody. She expects everyone to flourish. And in life, you're gonna need people that's gonna be your backbone. You're gonna need people that look at you and say, I'm expecting you to graduate. I'm expecting you. She may not say it in those words, but you know she's there to support you. And I love you for that, Ms. Jackson. And I want everyone to come up here and say something about you. I got you this nice little plaque. Ms. Jackson was like, maybe I should keep buying those trophies, but she didn't know I was getting her something too. And she always trying to ruin the surprise. So I'll have Jacqueline have something to say.
She gets a sub coming to her phone. And what's this charge right here?
Ms. Jackson, just let us do what we're doing.
We go over budget, we calculate, right? Like you said, Ms. Jackson is definitely someone you want to have in your corner. She's like my campus mom. For me, my mom passed several years ago, so Ms. Jackson has definitely filled that void while I've been in college. And I thank you for that. She's always there for advice. She calls me a little militant. I
don't know why. Because she calls me and she always calls me and I just thank you and love you so much. Okay, I'm going to keep this short and sweet. Ms. Jackson, you know I love you. My parents, they moved, so she's definitely been like my mama's, you know, since my mom, you know, lives, stays away or whatever. And she's always there for me and she always pushes me. And is there like literally every single time I meet her. So thank you for that. Thank you, Ms.
Jackson.
Coming into SPBC and as far as like being involved on campus, I really didn't expect the family that I gained. And yes, I would have to say Ms. Jackson is like another mother to me. Throughout anything that you need as far as advice or you just want to know when the next week event is coming up, Ms. Jackson is there and I thank you for everything you've done and as far as pushing me to do better and I love you.
I think Ms. Jackson's been in my life since freshman year. She was there, she knew I wanted to be an AKA but I'm jump. So I appreciate all she did for SPBC, been in all of our corners. She was there for me when I did homecoming, she was there for me when I did stroll off, she was just there. And sometimes the only thing we need is someone there. So I appreciate you.
Hey, how you doing? But on a serious note, I just want to say I appreciate you. Because you really pushed me to do things I never thought I would do, like the SBC. It was one of the first organizations I joined, and it really made me become a better person, I think. It made me come out of my shell, and I see the potential of me being a leader, and I want to say I appreciate you, and thank you for everything you do.
Okay, I
would definitely have to agree with everyone. Ms. Jackson is definitely like the mother, like, my other mom that I don't have. My mom, just like Kiana said, her mom is away. And so my mom was all the way in Nebraska. So whenever I'm stressed, I come to Ms. Jackson, I don't know what to do. She pray about it, just think it out, you know, come back to it and make a decision. But I feel like Ms. Jackson is one of the reasons why I have become a better leader. And I am willing to take risks and to get out of my shell. And I, like Debbie also said, I am one of the quiet ones, but being around exec and just having that push and motivation from Ms. Jackson has made me be willing to take risks. And I just want to say I love you, Ms. Jackson, and thank you for everything that you have done for not only me, but this exec board. Thank you.
I know Ms. Jackson since my freshman year.
situation and find better ways to handle the situations. So I thank you, Ms. Jackson, because it would work for you up in the meeting. So thank you.
Okay, yeah, everything that my executive said is definitely true. Ms. Jackson is a wonderful person, a great person. I don't like going to her office because she gives me a hard time about this code, but I know but I know that it's coming from a wonderful place, and I just want to say thank you for everything, and we love you.
SPBC as a whole sparked me to become more aware of my culture and
yourself, and for that, I'm thankful. So this person that you're seeing is all about Black power and uplifting the community. SPBC sparked that in me 4 years ago today. Well, not today, but 4 years ago. So for that, I'm thankful. To my exec, you all have been one of my biggest headaches my senior year, but I wouldn't trade any of it for anything. Through it all, we had some really good times, from keeping that to endless meetings and all the dance sessions in the office. You would just have to be in the office to know what that's about. The exec has taught me a lot about myself, and I thank each and every one of you for that. I won't name all of you one by one because we'll be here all night because we just have too many memories between everyone. But what I will say is, starting off with this exec, I had a really rough time because I'm really aggressive and I'm all about business. And a little bit of tent. And they were new, so they weren't really ready for that. So I had to step back, and because of that, a lot of the relationships didn't start off well. But here we are today, and I love all of them, and I have a very special relationship with them all. In closing, to the new exec, be yourself, uphold the legacy, be better than any other exec, and always represent Black Excellence.
Heart. A little background about myself. I dropped myself off first day of college. I had everything packed in my car, and my parents didn't drop me off. Didn't nobody was there for me. I pretty much had to support myself all throughout college by myself, and without SPBC, I don't know how I would have been. I remember my friends doing body meet. Joyce Spellman was, she was my mentor, and she invited me to the first meet. And she was like, come to room 215, that's our normal room or whatever. Thank you. That's our normal room, and we're gonna have our meeting there, et cetera. I came in, I was like 2 minutes late, and it was just packed out. You saw the picture. How happy you should be. And I walked in and she said, hey, Minty. And she said, that's Debbie Osha. Everybody turned around and said, hey, Debbie Osha. And I was like, all these people. I instantly felt at home. And one thing about home, sometimes it can get rough. And sometimes whatever you call home can build you up. It's gonna be people in your home that you're not gonna like. It's gonna be people in your home. Siblings, mother, whoever you call mother, daddy. And it's not going to be easy, but sometimes home is the one that builds you up and supports you. And I promise you, without James, Mary, Chase, and Matt, Ms. Jackson, Jacqueline, everybody on my exec board, they definitely kept me here, because one thing about it is I always felt alone, but when I come around them, I'm not alone anymore. So I don't have to have my family to come up here and support me. I have my family right here. And when I say I had some flaws and issues, I was so bad with time management. Now I show up to things early, thank God. And it was just certain things. I talk a lot, and I tried to change some things about myself that I know I need to change to be the career woman that I want to be. And I just thank SPBC. I can't even thank you. I've been a part of this organization for 5 years. I have put in countless of hours, and you know, I can never try to get that anywhere else, because this was my home and it built me to who I am today. And I just wanted to say thank you, and I am so proud of the new exec and where you're gonna take this organization. And I thank you guys for pushing me, because it's sometimes I wanted to quit. I said, I can't do this. It's just too much. But one thing about leadership, you have to have people that's going to push you, that have those ticks and those tacks. Because if you don't, you're not going to elevate. A lot of times people get in situations and they're scared and they run from their problems. And I didn't want to be a runner. I had to face my problems, and I had to face certain situations and say, okay, I'm going to take this head on and I'm going to elevate myself. And that's one thing. I know I'm speaking to someone in this room. Just accept yourself, you know, do whatever you can to others, love one another, and I thank all you guys, and I love y'all, and yeah.
Okay, so
every year the exec gets together and picks out a gift for the president as they leave. So here's your farewell gift. And I want you to go ahead and open up what's in the box so we can kind of tell the meaning behind it.
She's giving two purses now, so we like, and she likes to travel, so this will keep her from it. She's taking care of it. And inside the locket says, "SPBC, love, laugh." With these things inside of it, and she can always have it with her everywhere she goes.
Thank you guys. Oh, sorry.
Excuse me.